Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to make your own custom holiday greeting card with festive tinsel and holiday lights. I provided red and green glitter textures that you can download so you can follow along. Their links are located in the video description or project files. We'll make each into separate patterns that we'll use as textures inside the tinsel. We'll make the tinsel as a custom brush. Make a new layer by going to File and New. Make the width 200 pixels, the height 10 pixels, and the resolution 150 pixels per inch. We'll fill it with black. If your foreground and background colors aren't black and white respectively, press D on your keyboard. Now press Alt-Delete on a PC or Option-Delete on a Mac to fill it with the foreground color. Go to Edit and Define Brush Preset. Name it Tinsel. Click OK or press Enter or Return. Click on the small X on the tab to close the document and click No. Next, we'll make the green glitter into a pattern preset. Go to Edit and Define Pattern. Then click OK. Do the same for the red glitter. Edit and Define Pattern. Create a new document by pressing Ctrl or Command N. Make the width 1280 pixels, the height 720, and the resolution 150 pixels per inch. To fit it onto your screen, press Ctrl or Command 0. Let's make a soft, light blue vignette around the inside edges. Open your elliptical marquee tool, go to a corner, and drag across to the opposite corner. Go to Select and Transform Selection. Go to a corner, and when you see a straight double arrow, press Shift plus Alt on a PC or Shift plus Option on a Mac as you drag it in a little. Go to the middle and repeat the keystrokes and drag it down a little. Then press Enter or Return. Press Q to make it into a quick mask, and go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Blur it 67 pixels. Press Q again to revert the quick mask back into a selection, and then invert it by pressing Ctrl-Shift-I on a PC or Command-Shift-I on a Mac. Click on the foreground color and type in 99E8FF. Then press Enter or Return. Press Alt or Option plus Delete to fill the selection with the new foreground color. To delete the selection, press Ctrl or Command D. We're ready to make the tinsel. Open your brush tool and choose Large List. Scroll down to the bottom of the list and click Tinsel. In the Brush panel, under Brush Tip Shape, make the size 100 pixels and the spacing 200. Click Shape Dynamics. Keep all the controls off, the size jitter and minimum diameter 50%, the angle jitter 100%, the roundness jitter 50%, and the minimum roundness 100%. Click Scattering. Make the scatter 50% and check both axes. Keep both controls off. Make the count 5 and the count jitter 100%. Press the F5 key to close the brush panels. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. Place your brush half in and half out of the document and drag it all around the perimeter. Double-click the thumbnail to open its layer style window. Click Pattern Overlay and click the green texture. Click Outer Glow and the color box. Pick White and click OK. Change the blend mode to Dissolve and make the opacity and the noise 100%. Make the size 30 pixels and click OK. We're ready to type in the greeting. Open your horizontal type tool and choose a font. I'm using Bebas New. I provided its link in case you'd like to use it. I'll choose a size of 124 points, sharp, center alignment, and black for the color. Type out your text. To move the bottom line up, go to Window and Character. The character panel will open. Highlight the line and drag the baseline shift symbol to the right to slide up the text. To reposition it, click outside the text and move it. The tinsel will look better if your characters are widely spaced. To increase or decrease the space or tracking, highlight all the lines and slide the tracking symbol to the right or left. Close the character panel and open your Move tool. Control-click or Command-click on the thumbnail of your text to make it into a selection. Open your Paths panel and click on the icon in the upper right corner. Click on Make Work Path. Keep the tolerance at a default setting of 0.5 pixels. Open back up the Layers panel and hide the text. Click on the New Layer icon to make a new layer. Open your Brush tool and make the size 25 pixels. Open the Paths panel and click Stroke Path. Choose the Brush tool and click OK. To hide the paths, click anywhere in the empty area of the Paths panel, or you can press Ctrl or Command H. Open back up the Layers panel and double-click on the thumbnail of the tinsel text to open its layer style window. Click Pattern Overlay and click the red glitter. Keep the scale 100%. The lower the scale, the smaller the pattern will be. Click Drop Shadow. Make the opacity 30%, the distance 8 pixels, and the size 3 pixels. Then click OK. Next, we'll add the text at the bottom. Make the outer tinsel active. We'll place the text above this layer. Open your horizontal type tool and choose a font. This time, I'll use Freebooter Script. I provided its link as well. I'll make the size 30 points. Type out your text. Open your Move tool and move it. Click on the FX icon and choose Stroke. Make the size 3 pixels and the position outside. Click on the color box and pick white. Click Drop Shadow. Change the blend mode to normal and click on the color box. Type in 99E8FF. Then press Enter or Return. The distance is 5 pixels, the spread is 40%, and the size is 8 pixels. Then click OK. I'd like to make From a little smaller, so I'll press T to open my Type tool and highlight it. I'll reduce its point size to 20. To center all the text, click on your Move tool and Shift-click on the tinsel text layer to highlight all the text. Press Ctrl or Command A and click on the Align Horizontal Centers icon. To delete the selection, press Ctrl or Command D. To slide the text up or down, click on the layer to make it active and press the up or down arrow on your keyboard. I'll make the tinsel text active and slide it down. Next, let's add holiday lights to the green tinsel. First, Make a composite snapshot of your image by pressing Ctrl-Shift-Alt-E on a PC or Command-Shift-Option-E on a Mac. Go to Filter, Render, and Lens Flare. Choose Movie Prime for the lens type and make the brightness no more than 100%. Click on the lens flare and drag it to a location on your green Tinsel. Then click OK. Using the lens flare filter, continue making lights of varying opacities and locations on the green Tinsel until you're happy with the final image. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.